Hello everyone, I am Professor P.V. Shinde, Department of Soil Science and Agricultural Chemistry, KKWA College of Agriculture, Nasik. Today we are going to study vermicomposting under manures, fertilizers and soil fertility management for 5th semester. This video is only for education purpose, not for commercial use. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to define vermicompost, vermiculture, vermicomposting, importance of vermicompost, vermitechnology, vermiwash, method for preparation of vermicompost, chemical parameter of vermicompost. Vermicomposting has gained popularly in both industrial and domestic setting because as compared with conventional composting, it provides a way to treat organic wastage more quickly in manure composting. It also generates the products that have lower salinity levels. Let us see the definition of vermicompost. A compost which is prepared with the help of earthworms is called as vermicompost. Vermiculture. Vermiculture means scientific method of breeding and raising earthworms in controlled condition. Species of earthworms. There are 3,320 species of earthworms in the world. Out of these, 509 are found in India. The earthworm species are composting worms, most often used are red wigglers. That means Isenia foetida or Isenia andree. Red wigglers are recommended by most vermicomposting experts as they have some of the best appetites and breed very quickly. Here we see the importance of vermicompost. Vermicompost is costless and reliable. It maintains soil pH. It increases the drainage and water holding capacity of soil and decreases soil erosion. It adds attractive color and rich sources in fruits and vegetables. It increases humus percentage, which is helpful to increase proper root growth, which humus are rich in different nutrient. It also increases the soil fertility and productivity. As it increases the soil fertility and productivity, it contains different macronutrient and micronutrients which are slowly available to plants. Nutrient and micronutrients slowly available to soil and plants, which is required to growth of plants. It helps to generate employment. Vermiwash is used as a best fungicides which is collect from vermicompost, or we can say liquid collected from the vermicompost. In short, that vermicompost is very important source for improving the soil fertility and indirectly soil productivity, which are required to increase the crop yield. This figure show conceptual model of the potential role of vermicompost, that is in liquid and solid form, on pesticide degradation and transformation in soil. Here we can see the different role of solid vermicompost and liquid, like it enhances the microbial activity, it enhances the humic material, extracellular detoxification, it enhances the bioacidity, it acts as a surfactants, increase the organic matter. Vermitechnology. Vermitechnology is the combination of vermiculture and vermicomposting. Thus, earthworms can be used in the following areas: for development of arable soils, turnover of soil, breakdown of plant organic matter, aeration and drainage. For production of useful products like vermi fertilizers and worm tissue for animal feed, for maintenance of environmental quality and monitor of the environment, for soil fertility, organic and heavy metal, non-biodegradable toxic material pollution. Vermi wash is a liquid that is collected after the passage of water through a column of worm action and is very useful as a foliar spray of micronutrient or macronutrient. It is a collection of excretory production and mucus secretion of earthworms along with micronutrients from the soil organic molecules. This picture show how we collect vermi wash from vermicompost. This pipe show the collection of vermi wash. It is known that how we can prepare the vermicompost by using different waste material like agricultural wastage. Basic raw material which are required, any organic material generated in the farm like bhusa, leaf, fall, etc. Starter, cow dung, biogas slurry or urine of cattle. Species, that is Isinia foetida, we can use for preparation of vermicomposting because of their way to treat organic wastage more quickly in manure composting, and it is also used as for fast breeding. Favorable condition of earthworm in the composting material. It is very important point to know how we can create favorable condition for earthworm during the composting process, like pH may be ranges between 6.5 to 7.5. moisture is required in between 60 to 70%, below and above range moderately of worms taking place. Aeration, 50% aeration from the total pore spaces is required. 18 degree to 35 degree Celsius temperature is required for their favorable condition. Method for preparation of vermicompost. There are different method for preparation of vermicompost, but peat or heap method is very quick method or easy method for preparation of vermicompost. It is mostly prepared in either peat or heap method. The dimension either heap or peat are 10 by 4 by 2 feet. The length and width can be increased or decreased depending on the availability of material, but not the depth, because the earthworm activity is confined to the 2 feet depth only. Selection of earthworm. We can select the breed of worms like Isinia foetida, Idrillus eugena, Prevenoxys exhibitus, etc. Size of peat, 2 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter, can hold near about 10,000 to 40,000 worms. Preparation of vermi bed, a layer of 15 to 20 centimeter thick of good loamy soil above a thin layer of broken bricks and sand should be made. Inoculation of earthworm, near about 2000 earthworm we can inoculate in peat or heap. Organic layering, fresh cattle dung we can use for organic layering. 5 cm shredded organic litter of dry leaves or hay, it may be used for maintain the moisture level. After that organic layering, we should made the layer of wet organic That means after 4 weeks, moist green organic waste up to 5 cm. Practice is repeated, or this practice is repeated every 3 to 4 days till compost is nearly full. Harvesting. At the maturation of the material, moisture content is brought down, is removed, sieved and dried. It ensures, that means that drying ensures of compost and migration of compost into vermibed. Mature compost and it is packed into bag. After that harvesting of that vermicomposting, we should apply that vermicompost or recommend that vermicompost at the rate 5 tons per hectare for better result of the soil or crop yield. It is important to see the chemical parameter of vermicompost by which we know the how the vermicompost is important for improving the soil fertility. Vermicomposting containing water soluble nutrients is a nutrient rich organic fertilizer and soil conditioner in a form that is relatively easy for plant to absorb. Worm casting are sometimes used as an organic fertilizer because the earthworm grind and uniformly mix minerals in simple form in which plant need only mineral efforts to obtain them. The works digestive system create environments that allow certain species of microorganism to thrive to help create a living soil environment for soil. It is very important point that is that worms helps to create living soil environment for soil. There are different parameters like pH, organic carbon, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, iron, zinc, manganese. CN ratio is also important factor, copper and available sulfur. All these nutrients are available in vermicompost, which increase the fertility and productivity of the soil and also increase the crop yield, which are required for us. Also, CN ratio of vermicompost is narrow CN ratio, that is 20:1, and very favorable CN ratio for increase the microbial activity of the soil. Thank you very much.